Today I'm here with a new video, and today I am so excited. I am here with the first impression of the new palette from Kaleidos. Annette like was, I pronounced it wrong, she said, and I think I pronounced it as she does, and I think it should be Kaleidos. I don't know, but here it is. I got this in PR and I am so thankful for that, and it's like they asked me if I wanted this in PR and I was like yes. So today I am testing the Escape Pod, and this is bigger than their other palettes. I love the Futurism palettes. This is a little bit bigger. It is quite like a bulky package. I think I like it though. It looks like this, and then you open it like this. So it comes with a plastic thingy. So it looks like this, and it is 15 shades, and it's a little bit like raised. Yeah, I have to see what I'm doing. It's got a mirror, and I just really, really like it. Now I have been swatching some of the shades, but this is the close-up, and I really like this one. It's an escape button in the top corner, and you like see this green. I just want to play with this. So we will see what I will do. I think I know what I want to do. So I will just zoom in and we get started. Okay, so I think I want to do kind of like an orangey green look. So I think I will try to do like Carnival, Tango, and also Saturnalia? And maybe pop Starlight Sonata in my inner corner, or maybe like, yeah, we will see. So I think I will start with, a really dark like orange in my crease. Yes, I do. So this collection, it is called the Escape Collection, and it containing blushes, 3 new highlighters, and okay, can I get? Okay, wait now. Eyeshadow palette, 3 new highlighters, 2 dual blushes, 1 lip gloss, sponges, an eyeshadow primer, the palette. I think that was all. And I have the rest of the collection on the way home to me. I bought it and I am like, can you please come to my house now, because I really, really, really want it, and I'm so happy that they are releasing like more base products, because I like their highlighters. So when they came out with blushes, I was like, yes. So okay, what do I think about this? I like this orange. It is not like that popping orange. If you have the VR neon palette there, it's like one really, really like popping bright orange. This is like a really good orange. And I'm sorry if you hear the guys that are playing football outside. They do the strangest thing. It's a tennis court and they play football on it. And I'm like, not football, maybe say soccer. Yeah. And I'm like, you should play tennis. And they are like, yeah. They are like 10 guys or something, and all are like screaming. And now I will go in with Carnival and take it like out here, because I want the green shimmer on the rest, and we will see how this looks. I don't know, when I swatched this, it looked pretty like reddish. Maybe it's not that deep that I wanted it to be. But hey. Maybe I will go and deep it down with the dark brown in this palette. We will see how I feel. I'm just going to put this on. This shade was so easy to put down. And it blended together with the Tango. So, so good. Okay, I will try to just go in with this green. I thought when I opened the palette that this one and this one looked really similar. But when I swatched them, one of them looked more like a topper. These are them swatched, and I think this looks more like a topper shade, and this is like more one of Kaleido's normal, really opaque shimmers. So I'm going to take that one that is more opaque, or looks more opaque on my swatch, and it is this one. So I will take it in here. And yes, yes. Reddish and green. Okay, now we'll see. I really like this. I really do. I just hope that I am going to be able to blend these two together. But it feels like this is... How can I describe it? It is like... pretty opaque, but it's also like a little bit flaky. And if you ever want to blend together a matte and the shimmer, I think that is really good, because if it's a little bit flaky, it's easier to like get a little bit fade to it. Do I make any sense? Probably not. I really like this green. The only thing that I noticed like right away, and I think it was Annette that talked about that, they feel a little bit more like build up shadows. If you've tried any of the sci-fi, well, I almost say futurism palettes, they are really like opaque like that. You just put it on and it's opaque, it's so... like amazingly like opaque and shimmery, and I don't feel that this shadow is the exact same, but I can build it up, it's not a problem. And I think that Annette say the same, and nothing to complain about, it's just not the same as the other palettes. And it doesn't mean that these are, that older shades are better and these are not as good. I don't mean that at all. They are just different. But I still like it. But I actually think that I will try to go in with this terrace out here and just making it a little bit like deeper just in my outer corner. I hate when I try to deepen down like my outer corner and I take a shade that is so incredible pigmented, and it's like gets stuck on one place and I cannot like blend it out. I thought this shade was like that, but I can easily fix this. And I think this mirror is... the palette is, you can't bend it back, it's like this, so I think it's a little bit hard like to see up close, but okay. I think that this is something that I like. Okay, I actually feel like I will have it like this, because I think I need like my base and my under eyes to know if I really like this or not. So I'll fix my base and then we do the under eyes together. Okay, was I a little bit too heavy with the blush? Yes, I was. So, okay, for my under eyes, I'm going to take the Carnival and Terrace, and then I think I want to pop either Starlight Sonata or Galactic Gala in my inner corner. We will see. I will start with Carnival and just smudge this under my eye. And then I just pop dark brown out here to connect those a little bit. I actually think that I want to go in, with Galactic Gala in my inner corner, and I will spray. So I'll just pop it in here and a little bit down on my lower lash, a little bit up to the other green. So I like this, I actually do, except for the blush here. But I will put something in my wash line and choose a lippy. And I like want to go with the red lip. I don't think, but I go with red lip for like everything. I will see what I want to do. So I will take something in my wash line, put on mascara and a lippy, and then I am finished with the first impression look. So I couldn't help myself with red lippy. For my wash line I took, I never know what this is, Unt from ColourPop. For my lips I took one from Kaleidos. This is Collision. I love this. And yeah, that is the complete first look with the Escape Pod from Kaleidos. I must learn this. And I have used 5 shades. So I used Tango, Galactic Gala, Saturnalia, Carnival, and Terrace. And I really like this. It is, with the shimmers, I feel like a little bit different formula. Nothing that I complain about. It's not like that thick, I don't know, it's hard to describe if you never tried Kaleidos, but like a hard, not a hard, but like a thick opaque shimmer. This that I have in my inner corner, that was Saturnalia. This one, I think it looks really good. It had to build up a little bit, but like the mattes I tried, amazing. And I really liked that this dark brown was easy to like deepen down my outer corner, and it was easy to blend in with others. So yeah, my first impression of this is good. I am so excited that they are releasing more, because I just want everything, and it's going to be so fun when I get my package with the base things, because I just want to try them. So yeah, I really hope you like this video, and if you're not subscribed to my channel, please do, so don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!